hermanos. I should say, welcome back. I see so many of you who are regulars here. We are huge fans of Mr. Robert Hitz. I asked Robert how many students he has, and he really couldn't answer me. He's kind of like the little old woman who lived in the shoe, right? One thing we are certain of, there's no greater educator or collaborator that I know of. So. And you all, you who will be performing tonight, you're the proof. All right, now with that, let me welcome you to the show.
Thank you.
Is now. We've got a really great show for you tonight. It is lots of music that is unforgettable. My name is John Wilson, and I'll be your MC, be introducing people along the way. And our next performer is Bryan McDonald, who's making his premiere with the Robert Hitz Studio. He is singing One Perfect Moment from the musical Bring It On.
Okay, so my name is Bryan. I'm excited to be performing for you guys tonight in my premiere performance of, I guess, Robert's studio. This song is from a musical called Bring It On. Very, very obscure. I like obscure musicals. It's kind of what I do.
That's what I'm about.
It's a motivational song. I'm going to take it from the perspective rather than the cheerleader perspective, if you're familiar with the movie. I'll take it from the perspective of my life as a performer. I guess here we go, bring it on. I'm not freaking out, I'm really okay. I'm totally chill, or I will be someday. Cause I'm so near the top. But there's so many mountains to climb. There are plans to be planned, drills to be drilled. Cause this dream that I dreamed is becoming fulfilled. And I plan to enjoy it. But right now, I don't have the time. Fading on Campbell, an average teenager, almost grown. Close up on average grades from the average life he's known. Now zoom in the lens on the rest of his friends as he stays alone. unmasking is one perfect moment in time. I'm 17, there are so many things that I can't control. If I start to freak or feel weak, I focus on just one goal. Turn down the panic, attack this routine like it owns my soul. Turn up the music so loud that it swallows us whole. And then there we are, we burn like a star inside the world we thought we'd know. Then suddenly I'm in breath for the climb, and here I go, high in the air. There is a moment just before you start to fall. Live in that one moment, 'cause I know that if I can just stick the landing, then I'll know that the rest of my life will be fine. So I'll go through the rest of my life understanding what it feels like to shine. My one perfect moment in time. Thank you.
Thank you, Bryan, for giving us one perfect moment. Speaking of perfect moments, this song describes one of those in a very familiar musical. I'm sure you've all know My Fair Lady. And we have Evan Alexander to sing On the Street Where You Live.
Hello, everyone. So this next song is On the Street Where You Live, as John said. And this song, to me, is about when everything is going just right, and you're finally, you know, finding something that you can really cling to and be happy with. So that's what I think this song is about. Traditionally, it's a love song, but I suppose it can also be unforgettable because you can love life and not forget all the people that mean so much to you.
I have often never stayed beneath my feet before. All at once am I several stories high, knowing I'm on the street where you live. Are there lilac trees in the heart of town? A lark in any other part of town? Does enchantment pour out of every door? No, it's just on the street where you live. You may suddenly appear. stop and stare. They don't bother me, for there's nowhere else on earth that I would rather be. Let the time go by, I won't care if I can be here on the street where you live.
Thank you.
Thank you, Evan. Well, up next is Evan's brother, Ethan. You are not seeing double. They are brothers. And Ethan will sing the title song of our program tonight, Unforgettable.
Hello. So this song was made popular by Nat King Cole. It's called Unforgettable. And for me, I like this song because it's unforgettable. I seriously have never forgotten the lyrics after like 2 years. So it's really fun to do, and I hope you guys enjoy it.
Unforgettable, that's what you are. Unforgettable, though near or far, like a song of love that clings to me, how the thought of you does things to me. Never before has someone been more unforgettable in every way, and forevermore that's how you'll stay. That's why, darling, it's incredible that someone so unforgettable thinks that I am unforgettable too. Someone so unforgettable thinks that I am unforgettable too.
Thank you.
Very good.
Up next, we have a real treat.
He's sitting there.
Eliyahu Kheel is favoring us tonight with a preview of 2 songs from a musical he's writing. Mm-hmm. He'll sing one as a solo, and Ora Chaya Brock will join him for a duet for the second one. And he'll tell you a little bit about the project and the songs.
Hi. So I'm writing a musical based on the book/movie Marley and Me, if
anyone knows it. There we go. Got some fans in the audience. So, it's about this family and their dog, basically. And this, at this point in the show, John, the main character, has been going through all these troubles with his job and with his family and kids and everything. And Marley has been the only one getting him through this. So, this is the title song, Marley and Me. But there's something more between us. There is something deep inside, like the burning glow of fire in my heart. 'Cause I know that in this madness, there's a place and there's a time when I can just look up and see your heart in mine. Just the days passing by, just the way the time flies when I'm with you. When I first saw your face, my pain was erased, 'cause this clearance pump has made me see the light. Yes, 'cause Marley and me will always be. 'Cause I feel the love rushing out of my heart, flooding my soul with the joy only a dog can bring. 'Cause I feel so alone when you're not here. 'Cause that chill of her has made my feelings dark. And I look into your eyes, those big black chocolate eyes, and I see the love I always knew was there. And now as I sing these words, they could remain unspoken true. Because you knew, Marley, you know I'll always be right here. Just the days passing by, just the way the time flies when I'm with you. When I first saw your face, all my pain was erased, 'cause this clearance pump has made me see the light. Yes, 'cause Marley and me will always be. 'Cause that clearance pump and me, my love will always be. Just Marley. As she's coming to the stage, I'll tell a bit about this next song. This is the Act 1 closer to the show, and it takes place as John and Jenny. Jenny has just taken a pregnancy test. So the song actually takes place during three different scenes. When it starts, they're waiting for the pregnancy test to show the result. As the song goes along, you'll hear an instrumental, and at the end of the instrumental, they find out that it's positive and that she is pregnant. She's excited. So, So then move forward, and there's another instrumental to skip 3 months into the future when she's having a sonogram. And we find out that it's a miscarriage. Nice and peaceful.
I promise the song is positive.
So this is I'm Positive I Love You.
Take the step and see it through. That would be a lie. To tell the truth, this future scares me so. 'Cause I'm positive I love you. I'm sure the signs above. Whatever the future brings us.
Yes,
whatever comes, I'm positive. I know
that thing. That's why I bought you coffee, and you would have brought me coffee. My man's stand right there.
It weren't so. I need you more than ever as this baby disappears. So tell me that you still love me so. 'Cause I'm positive I love you.
I'm sure the signs above, whatever the future brings us, I know we'll see it through. Love will not be fading,
and now that four is over, our signs above will show. I'm positive I love you.
because I'm holding you. My love has seen it through. Cause throughout it all, I'm positive. I love you.
Another performer who's premiering with the Robert Hintz Studio this evening, Lydia Wine, will be singing Till There Was You from The Music Man. Welcome to Lydia. Immortalized by Roberta Flack in the 70s called The First Time Ever I Saw Your Face.
The first time ever I saw your face, I thought the sun rose in your eyes.
to the dark and empty skies, my love, to the dark and empty skies.
Where we played it time and time again on the jukebox. Sorry. We're just having a moment. We're going to shift things up here for a moment and invite Chloe Smith to come to the piano. She's going to play for us Beethoven's Bagatelle. Welcome, Chloe. Thank you.
Is there Andy? There Andy? He's almost sleeping. No, one of the reasons I especially asked Chloe to play that is because Beethoven, that was written about 1810, and everyone else at that time, I mean, music has never been the same since Beethoven. Everyone was supposed to... You know, we're so very, very different, very classical, very, very different. He just blew the top off of the art world in terms of music, and it's never been the same since.
Awesome. To close out the first half of our program, we have Terry Hall and Don Romano singing the love theme from The Godfather. Am I spilling beans here?
Yeah.
Oh, sorry. With the song Speak Softly, Love.
Speak softly, love, and hold me warm against your heart. I feel your words, the tender, trembling moment start. Were it a world our very own, sharing a love that only few have ever known.
One color days warmed by the sun, deep velvet nights when we are one. Speak softly, love, so no one hears us but the sky. The vows of love we make will live until we die. My life is yours, and all because you came into my world with love so softly.
March 13th, am I correct? Is March 13th is our very first. Mary Riley is our master cabaret artist, and we really welcome all of you. We look forward to hearing you here at our open mic night. We heard some exquisite piano playing tonight, absolutely gorgeous, and we have concert pianist Richard Dowling coming Easter for two shows, a brunch and a dinner performance. He is really unbelievable, so if you haven't made plans, please join us. Also, for those of you who are cabaret fans, Steve Ross, the iconic Steve Ross, will be here, and just so many others. We're very fortunate to have an incredible community of local talent here, but we're also very fortunate that this venue attracts people from outside of Baltimore, in this country and outside of this country. Adrienne West will be here April 2nd. She is... Oh, do you know Adrienne?
I know her.
She lives in Amsterdam. She's from New York. She's very well known in Europe and loved, beloved. So when you hear her, you will become fans as well. And now, are we ready to...
We have a drum roll for
something. And... The answer is
Yvonne de Bruin. Congratulations.
So, can I
do you want to talk?
Yeah, I do want to talk
for
a minute.
Go ahead and talk.
Okay, but because a lot of people said they couldn't come tonight because right about now, the last show of Downton Abbey, which, is a television thing. So all about television, like it has to be live, it has to be television, but at least there aren't so many commercials. But glad your guys are here.
And we will have no spoiler alert. What happens tonight. It's always such a great pleasure to be here at Germano's, and we want to thank Sid and Germano for welcoming us time and time again. It's just wonderful to be here. And I think we also should give a big round of applause to Robert Hitz. Amazing. I think many of you know that the studio is rather unique in many ways. People study piano, people study composition, people do vocal coaching, people learn to write songs. There's so much that goes on there. And on top of that, the performance opportunities that folks that work with Robert get on a regular basis in this town and often in this space is truly remarkable. So. Yeah. Let's give a big round of applause to Robert.
Sid is a really big supporter of us here, so please remember her. Remember the wonderful wait staff here. They are great, their crew. So give them a big round of applause.
So we're going to continue. We're going to invite Eliyahu Kheel back to the microphone for a little ditty called Telly, which is quite amusing, and I don't know whether you have anything to say or whether you just want to take it away.
So who here reads books?
Not me.
You're boring. Now who here watches television? There we go. These are the smart people. Downton Abbey, right here. So I got a little story to tell about television. Somewhere on a show I heard that a picture tells 1,000 words. So Telly, if you bothered to take a look, is the equivalent of like lots of books. All I know I learned from Telly, this big beautiful box of facts. If you know a thing already, maybe you should switch a channel over just like that. And this join in this laughter. Folks living happily ever after. All you need to make you wise is 23 minutes plus advertisements. Why would we waste our energy turning the pages 1, 2, 3 when we could sit happily on our lovely bapolis, watching people singing and talking and doing stuff? All I know I learned from Telly. Bigger Telly, the smarter the man. You can tell from my big Telly just what a clever fella I am. Take it away, Robert. You can't learn that from a stupid book. All I know I learned from Telly, what to think and what to buy. I was pretty smart already, but now I'm really smart, very, very smart. Endless content, endless channels, endless chat on endless panels. All you need to fill your muffin without having to really think or nothing. Why would we waste our energy trying to work out other seas when we could sit comfortably on our lovely bumperlies, watching slightly famous people talking about really famous people? All I know I learned from Telly. The bigger the Telly, the smarter the man. You can tell from my big Telly just what a clever fella I am. Who the Dickens is Charles Dickens? Mary Shelley, cause she sounds smelly. Harry Potter, what a rotter. Jane Austen in the composting. James Joyce doesn't sound nice. Ian McKellen, I feel like spewing. William Shakespeare, William Shakespeare. Moby Dick, he's a grandma. All together now.
Continue the fun, we're going to invite Ethan Alexander back to the microphone for a song I think you all know. I won't even name it.
It's from a recent movie, isn't it?
Agent 006, you must go to Germano's and perform as well as you possibly can in order to impress the audience. If you don't, you will fail your mission. Strangers in the night, exchanging glances, wandering in the night. What were the chances we'd be sharing love before the night was through? Something in your eyes was so inviting, something in your smile was so exciting, something in my heart told me I must have you. Strangers in the night, two lonely people, we were strangers in the night. Up to the moment when we said our first hello, little did we know, love was such a glance away, a warm embracing dance away. And ever since that night, we've been together, lovers at first sight, in love forever. It turned out so right for strangers in the night. I'll have a martini, shaken, not stirred. Something in your eyes was so inviting, something in your smile was so exciting, something in my heart told told me I must have you. Strangers in the night, two lonely people, we were strangers in the night, up to the moment when we said our first hello. Little did we know, love was such a chance away, a warm embracing dance away. And ever since that night, we've been together, lovers at first sight, in love forever. It turned out so right for strangers in the night.
Thank you, 006. Up next, Don Romano is going to be singing an original piece called Hindsight. Once she's set up here, I guess I should crib a little bit, tell a joke or something. Do you want to tell us about your song?
Sure. This is the most recent song that I wrote, and it reminds me not to take life too seriously. Find out the hard way. Gotta be on the move, and then try again. Searching far and wide, never been one to seek or hide.
Thank you.
must reach inside of you. Say, baby, won't you take a chance and see who you meet? Get back upon your feet, try again before you admit defeat. Why don't you take a turn beyond usual? Don't take it personal, just breathe, and you'll be free.
Thank you. We also have another original composition up next, by Ora Chaya, a piece called When I'm Cold. And I think you have a story about that to tell us, right?
Kind of,
maybe. Ish. You kind of like the opportunity to talk to us, don't you?
I love talking to people.
I know you do. Welcome, Ora Chaya.
Hi, everyone. Okay. So, there's not much behind this song. it's a really deep song. So basically, it was raining outside, and I was just playing on the piano, and I came up with this really gorgeous melody, but I wanted to, like, put lyrics to it, and the melody reminded me very strongly of death, like, of people passing away and stuff like that, and I didn't want to just write a gorgeous song that, you know, makes everyone want to cry. I want to, like, have a positive twist to it. So this was my attempt at a positive twist to death. I hope you guys enjoy it. Maybe a little bit. Oh my goodness, it's like magic. Okay, all right, I got this. Will you sing for me? Will you cry for me? time may be gone, but in your memories, I will live on. When you're cold, I will remember you, who you were. When you're dust, I will let you with the wind. I won't forget you, I might have cried, but my tears won't see my face. Just close my eyes, yes, you'll be here. You will rest deep in my heart, deep in my heart.
Song from a movie, which happened to be my very favorite movie when I was 10 years old. It is from the classic Elvis Presley film, Blue Hawaii. And we're going to invite Lydia Wine to return to the stage, where she will be supported by Dawn and Sean and me.
Yay!
Can't help falling in love.
Wise men say
what'd you go running away for? We need you back up here. Girlfriend. Here's another American movie classic that you all know. Welcome Bryan McDonald back to the stage. Were there birds? Sid, can we get those birds out of here? The song is called Role of a Lifetime, and it's from another obscure musical, I think. Yes? Will you tell us a little about it, Bryan?
Okay, so following trend, I'm back at it with another obscure musical. This one's called Bear. Very few people know it. Follows a group of high school students in a Catholic school with a whole range of issues and craziness we don't need to get into right now. However, the two lead characters are homosexual and they have a relationship, and it, as the show progresses, it crumbles, it falls apart, and it's a mess. So this is, I want to say, like the second or third song in the show. This showcases kind of the turning point for the relationship. There's a response to it at the end of the show, conveniently, but I don't have that for you today. So without further ado, here's Role of a Lifetime. Everything's an act when you're pleasing everyone, and he assumes that role to such renown. He plays the perfect part straight from his heart, knowing the risk he takes, hoping that the house is not brought down. The role of a lifetime is living a fantasy, a drama that you struggle to erase. Thoughts battle words over deeds, a war with such casualties, all played out behind a smiling face. God, I need your guidance. Tell me what it means to live a life where nothing's as it seems. Spending days in silent fear and spending nights in lonely prayer, hoping that one day when you wake, those feelings won't be there. So confused because I feel complete with him. When we're alone, it all somehow makes sense. Look into his eyes for some compromise. Remember the word forget and try to bury something so intense. You learn to play the straight man. Your lines become routine. Never really saying what you mean. But I know the scene will change. White picket fences and a dog, a trophy bride and children. God, I know that's what he wants. But Jason, what role do I play? Am I a savior or a phase? Am I here to damn you or to help you navigate this maze? Where confusion is a crime, so you fill your life with sound. And if you dance like hell, you hope you'll never touch the ground. But what happens when the music stops? In the silence, will he stay? One day you'll realize that these feelings aren't going away. So we drive ourselves insane, spinning circles in our souls as we dance around and play pretend. Then once again, reprise our roles.
Also thank the invisible crew behind the scenes that make this evening possible too. Randy Hayes on the soundboard, Ora Chaya on the video camera. Thank you so much. Make the evening more special and more complete. We're going to go with another musical. This is a song from another musical, Beauty and the Beast by Eliyahu Kheel. The song is If I Can't Love Her, and he has a wonderful story to share. That's great news.
Does that guy pick his songs for him or not?
Hi again. So, speaking of a role of a lifetime, I'm going to be making my off-Broadway debut as the Beast this May, starting May 14th. Woo! So, I mean, what else is there? If anyone's in New York May 14th, come see it. It's gonna be awesome. My tortured shape, no comfort, no escape. I see but deep within is utter blindness, hopeless as my dream dies. As the time flies, love, a lost illusion. Helpless, unforgiven, cold and driven to this sad conclusion. No beauty can move me, no goodness prove me, no power on earth if I can't love her. No passion could reach me, no lesson could teach me how I could have loved her and make her love me too if I can't love her. Long ago I should have seen all the things I could have been. Careless and unthinking, I moved onward.
Tonight is unforgettable, and you've heard many unforgettable songs today. Now, you may hope that we, the human race, are unforgettable, but sadly, we are not. There are many things that could end us, be it asteroids, famine, war, who knows, maybe presidential debates. But one thing that could happen are bombs, and these bombs aren't pretty. So, here's a light-hearted yet heavy-handed song. Or was it the other way around? When you attend a funeral, it is sad to think that sooner or later those you love will do the same for you. And you may have thought it tragic, not to mention other adjectives, to think of all the weeping they will do But don't you worry. No more ashes, no more sackcloth, and an armband made of black cloth will someday nevermore adorn a sleeve. For if the bomb that drops on you gets your friends and neighbors too, there'll be nobody left behind to grieve. And we will all go together when we go. What a comforting fact that is to know. Universal bereavement, an inspiring achievement. Yes, we all will go together when we go. We will all go together when we go. All suffused with an incandescent glow. No one will have the insurance to collect on his insurance. Lloyds of London will be loaded when they go. We will all fry together when we fry. We'll be French fried potatoes by and by. There will be no more misery when the world is our rotisserie. Yes, we all will fry together when we fry. And we will all bake together when we bake. There'll be nobody present at the wake. With complete participation in that grand incineration, nearly 7 billion hunks of well-done steak. We will all char together when we char, and let there be no moaning at the bar. Just sing out unto Diem when you see that Icerium, and the party will become as you are. We will all burn together when we burn. There'll be no need to stand and wait your turn. When it's time for the fallout and St. Peter calls us all out, we'll just drop our agendas and adjourn. You will all go directly to your respective Valhallas. Go directly, do not pass go, do not collect 200 dollars. And we will all go together when we go. Every Anton and every Eskimo. When the air becomes Uranus, we will all go simultaneous. Yes, we all will go together when we all go together. Yes, we all will go together.
Good night, everyone, and when you go, may you all go together.